Hello all, my name is Tim. I go by Autumn. Thank you for being here and for donating to a great cause. Today I want to talk about Confluence, which is a way of organizing information about markets. Lots to say about Confluence, but for today's purposes, the key thing to know about a Confluence lens is that it's designed to be completely anti-hindsight in nature, not reliant at all on hindsight for clarity. And so to that end, what I did for today's presentation is I pulled thousands of people on Twitter and asked them to select a couple of sessions over the last few weeks for us to analyze together and dive in. And that way we're avoiding the hindsight and cherry picking that so often goes along with a presentation like this. We'll be going over the sessions of October 2nd and October 6th, which were by far the most voted for sessions. And let's get right into it. So here's my screen. What you're looking at here is the futures products for the three main American stock indices. So on the top is ES, the E-mini S&P 500 futures product. On the left is the regular trading hours, 9:30 to 4 Eastern. And on the right is all hours, so all around the globe that trades basically 24/7 with a brief pause. In the middle, NASDAQ futures, tech futures, NQ is the product's name. RTH on the left side, all hours on the right side. And on the bottom is the Russell 2000 small cap index futures product, RTY, RTH on the left side, ETH on the right. Key thing to know, these are shorter time frame 5 minute charts. And we've built our technology in a way that everything on here is from a higher time frame chart and effortlessly transported onto these shorter time frame charts. It's our opinion that a huge part of edge in modern markets, a huge part of organizing information efficiently, comes from technology like this that makes the day-to-day behavioral task of execution as easy and definitive and clear as possible so that you can see the most important and relevant information, even if you are executing on the quote-unquote day trade time frame, so the shorter time frame. The one thing to know here for this presentation, we're only going to be using or viewing two of the many Confluence system tools, two of the most salient and powerful tools at the beating heart of the system, two of a dozen or so. So this is a bare minimum, but still the beating heart, namely higher time frame pivot points and what we call supply and demand levels. Pivot points are the color shaded zones and supply and demand are the gray shaded zones with the black bands. Supply and demand levels are very powerful, manually drawn zones that act as support and resistance and help us add a piece to a Confluence case for a reversal. We're not using any of the other system tools like Anchored VWAP or what we call real breadth, which are levels in the individual stock constituents of the ecosystem, which give us huge clues and a huge edge day in and day out. Can you trade the Confluence system just using these two tools that we're covering today? Absolutely. That's exactly the point of what I'm showing you. You can take chunks of profit out of the market all day just using these two or couple or several of powerful system tools. No other info, supply and demand levels, and the pivot points are fixed and static. Supply and demand levels are drawn on the contract roll and they stay. They're not curve fit. There's no tweaking so that they fit every little reversal perfectly. You can go back to my old tweets and you will see that these levels are the same day in and day out. Pivot points work the same way. They're fixed and concrete on whatever time frame they're calculated from. So just like the supply and demand levels, they're automatically plotted on our charts via technology. A given week will have its fixed and static weekly pivot points. A given month, the same. A given quarter, the same. A given year, the same. There's nothing to move or change. They are what they are. Whether they work perfectly or completely fail, none of this is curve fit. Last two things to talk about, gap fills. So prior sessions, untested closes, represented here by the yellow dashed lines, and naked VPOCs, volume points of control, are the white dashed lines you see here on the right side of the charts, which is just the most traded price of a prior session, something futures traders will be very familiar with. So in summary, just a little bit of engineer technology. We have these higher time frame reference points and indicators on our shorter time frame execution charts. Everything on this chart is concrete and definitive. Nothing is curve fit. And just using that framework, let alone the whole robust Confluence lens, we can easily build a consistent and repeatable process for taking chunks of profit out of the market day in, day out. No guesswork, no holding and hoping a signal turns into a home run, no curve fitting, no hindsight. And this goes back to a question I always ask, which is, who do you want to be as a trader? For us, the answer to that important question was consistency, having an edge that didn't rely on hindsight and subjectivity. And the Confluence system you're about to get a glimpse of was designed with exactly that in mind. Let's dig in. So first in focus here is the very active session, Friday, October 2nd, 2020. very active overnight session with President Donald Trump contracting COVID-19. Very news flow driven move down. Right around the Europe Open, we get a massive Confluence long signal with NQ holding weekly R1 and quarterly pivot point. Remember, that's a brand new quarterly pivot point as this is October 2nd. We're 2 days into a fresh set of quarterly pivot points. RTY, you'll see at the lows here, holds quarterly pivot point and the supply and demand level. What else is present at that lows? It's the daily anchored VWAP here to the tick on that day, October 2nd. No hindsight in how that VWAP is drawn. The origin point is just simply the swing low. ES comes down just shy of the supply and demand level. Looks like a miss or really nothing there, but it as well is the daily anchored VWAP just drawn from the swing low, and it just got a point or two below. So pretty perfect there. Confluence long signal. You'll see that that ultimately went level to level or signal to signal, as we say. You'll see that all indices bounced up and how many pieces of evidence were present at the high. So the 20-day exponential moving average, remember that's that daily moving average transported to the lower time frame via technology. Also present at the late pre-market highs in ES, WR1, supply and demand, and VWAP, NQ, huge level supply and demand, and VWAP, RTY, monthly pivot point, the 50-day exponential moving average, and supply and demand, and then all the way back down. So setting the stage for the RTH open here. ES retesting the daily anchored VWAP. There's a little shorter time frame trend line, if you will, there. NQ retesting these levels, adding the 20-day exponential moving average and the naked point of control. RTY retesting that key cluster of three very significant pieces of evidence at the lows: quarterly pivot point, daily anchored VWAP, and supply and demand. So we rip up into the open. This is already a 30-point trade in ES, 130-point trade in NQ, and a 20 or so point trade in RTY. You see ES pauses at the quarterly pivot point and the 20-day exponential moving average. RTY pauses at supply and demand. And we don't get to decide what the market is going to do. It does what it wants. It's about taking what it wants to give, not what we want to have. So ES, could it have pulled back more from this little confluence moment? Sure, but it pulls back into weekly R1 and supply and demand and session VWAP and holds. RTY, shallow pullback into monthly pivot point, intraday VWAP, and the 50-day exponential moving average, and hold. So it's a get out of the way moment, or a continuation long, as we call it. And then we come up into the first very significant confluence sell in the RTH hours here. I'm going to play a clip real quick from our pre-market strategy video that we do every morning, 90 minutes before the open. That will show that this was the key level, this confluence moment in time, ES coming up into supply and demand. NQ into supply and demand, and surf is the black signal line in both ES and NQ. Very important algo-driven kind of trade management reference point. Almost miraculous in its efficacy at times. RTY up into supply and demand, just shy of gap fill. This was the main level from our pre-market prep. The point of sharing this is not at all to glorify calls or nice call. We don't care about that stuff at all, and neither should you. The point is, however, to highlight how much of this is viewable in advance with a confluence lens versus needing hindsight for clarity, like so many other ways of organizing information. How clear and pristine, concrete and definitive these levels. We don't know when the moments of time are going to occur. That's path dependent, but the levels are clear. Take a look at this clip from our pre-market prep from about 90 minutes before the open.
Below that, much more key level supply and demand, trend guide, and gap fill, keying more on this lower edge. That was also yesterday's real-time hour low. Also, we tested it once, popped back up, and then sold off from there. So this is key level, very key level.
And so as you just saw, here we are, RTY, supply and demand, NQ, supply and demand. It'll interact with surf there to the tick in just a second. ES already fading from that key level from the pre-market prep, supply and demand, the daily S1, or what we call trend guide, and surf. Big confluence moment. ES and RTY have relative strength. Really, RTY is the relative strength member here. NQ is very relative weak and has been for the week that the week that this day was included in. So NQ will never recover from this very significant sell level. ES will end up retesting it before setting up the second confluence long of the day. You can see RTY here goes supply and demand to supply and demand. That's a 12-point trade. NQ from the upper end of supply and demand, and surf is already a 60-point chunk, and ES is a 10-point chunk from, actually, no, it's a 20-point chunk. It's a 20-point chunk from the level just back to the supply and demand and the weekly R1. So what you set up here is ES, weekly R1, supply and demand from above, with RTY testing the supply and demand. It's the same moment in time. Not a screaming confluence signal, but you can see it's very orderly and structural. And so that leads to RTY is going to make a marginally higher high here. We call this a divergence or a frustration process. This is how markets work. It's the market's job here to punish and frustrate sellers who called to have their stops against that high. I think that that's the line in the sand, and trap a bunch of weak hand buyers who are trading some perceived breakout. And then ES is retesting the supply and demand and the trend guide the same level. NQ can't even get back above SURF. So then you're getting a retest or a divergence process in RTY while NQ goes to the lows. Now, this is a little confluence moment here. Could this have held? ES, weekly R1, supply and demand. NQ, that same level from pre-market, weekly R1 and quarterly pivot point, RTY and supply and demand. Those are levels. You can see the buyer emergence there. You can see the attempt by buyers. It's very inside, so it would be an avoid for us. But that is definitively a moment from a confluence perspective, and it just fails. What it does set up here is the second screaming confluence long of the day. You'll remember the one was pre-market, just before the open, being retested at the open, essentially. And we set up another one here. So I'm going to play another clip from the pre-market strategy video that shows that this was the key level on the downside. So you'll recall ES and RTY had hit their daily anchored VWAPs pre-market, and Q had not. It'll do so now. You'll see us talking about this in this clip.
So this level right here, kind of just below, just held the 20 there. Yeah, you know what? I probably should move this one down to the lower edge. This probably should be down like this to capture 11,224. Yeah, something like this. Then you have the daily anchored VWAP there too.
Okay, so as you just saw, about 11 a.m. Central, we're going to get this screaming confluence long. ES, look, supply and demand, the 50-day exponential moving average. RTY, the intraday anchored VWAP or regular trading hour session VWAP, however you want to say that. And NQ finally coming down to collect its daily anchored VWAP there. You can see no BS on the origin point of the daily anchored VWAP. And the low was just a few points, a handful of points away from the daily anchored VWAP. So another big confluence long across the board. That's one of the bread and butter, very significant confluence moments in a given day. That's a 40-point trade already from ES. In ES, excuse me, that's a 25-point trade in RTY and 150-point trade in NQ already. It'll be much more, but huge chunk there, and it sets up the last confluence sell of the day. ES supplying that same level, and now it's doing the divergence process. Notice the marginally higher high that traps buyers of a perceived breakout and punishes sellers who just arbitrarily assign their stops on these on this double top or poor high, if you will. And now we set up the last confluence sell of the day. ES supply and demand, trend guide from below. NQ supply and demand, weekly R1, quarterly pivot point from below. RTY and ABCD, I can't draw it because it's a video, but it's AB equals CD on the upside, perfect symmetry, as you might say, into an additional piece of evidence, weekly R2, right? So that'll be the last confluence chunk. NQ already fading about 50 points from the supply and demand, weekly R1, quarterly pivot point before trying a little bounce at the 20-day. ES still just digesting the level. No, the signal hasn't been quote unquote harvested, like we might say. No signal resolution to speak of there yet. RTY gave 5 points back to SURF and the supply and demand so far. Maybe that's where it stops. We don't know. No confluence long signal, so we might expect that to keep going. And here we go. Here we get the resolution of the last confluence sell. ES still just digesting the signal. There we go. There's a little break. So that's a 15-point trade just back to quarterly pivot point in 20 EMA. It'll be a 20-point trade back to supply and demand to supply and demand type of level to level. RTY is a 15-point trade as well, just back to that same liquidity reference point, that same VWAP that it's stair-stepping up at relative strength, 15 points from ABCD weekly R2 into supply and demand. And Q now is about 100 points from supply and demand. And ES, again, 15 points from level to level there. And the rest of the day is very similar. I'll fast forward here. Just kind of bounces in between level to level. Our day is done, right? We took the main chunks out of the market. We took this pre-market long with evidence across the board, which turned into the mid-morning short, about 10 going into 11 central, and then the massive long, RTH long with NQ collecting that daily anchored VWAP that you saw from the pre-market prep video, from the highs that were this key level and ES that you saw in the pre-market prep video. Those are our main chunks. You know, we're not looking to ride this thing all the way into the close, but if you notice how it closed, I mean, we essentially just did a level to level. I mean, ES is giving 10 to 15 point chunks from supply and demand to supply and demand, quarterly pivot point and 20 EMA. You can see they're also holding. NQ is doing the same exact thing, guys. Again, this is concrete and definitive. We're not tweaking these levels. Look at NQ just bounce in between supply and demand, with weekly R1 and quarterly pivot point also playing a role. Those are 80, 60, 80, 100, 120 point chunks, not ticks. Points in NQ, 15 points in ES, not ticks, points. That's real money. That's the way a system was designed, is to be able to take money out of the market in that fashion, in a consistent way, a repeatable way that doesn't need hindsight to be clear and concrete. So in focus now, the session Tuesday, October 6th. This was a very bread and butter confluence session with four bread and butter kind of confluence signals, and then an epic climax as three massive levels that were identified in the pre-market strategy session hit all at the same time, same window of time, and then an exogenous news item hit, and you got an epic signal resolution from those key levels. Can't make this stuff up, don't necessarily know how to explain it, but something we see time and time again with exogenous inputs happening at definitive concrete system levels that are visible in advance, which I will show you. Pretty quiet overnight session leading up into this RTH open. ES had a nice supply and demand, those are 10-point chunks back and forth. RTY, I guess, had a nice supply and demand short, but into the open, RTY comes up into supply and demand, and monthly R1, ES into that naked VPOC just above the overnight highs, and Q kind of middle of nowhere. That sets up the first of the four confluence bread and butter signals for the day. Same moment in time here, coming into about 9 central, you can see NQ, bottom end of supply and demand, intraday pivot point, ES, bottom end of supply and demand, and RTY, bottom end of supply and demand, with surf catching up there. You know, no home run there, but it's the same definitive moment in time with three clear levels that were visible in advance and not kerfit, all active. And that's a, you know, 10, 15 point trade in ES so far. It's a 80 point trade in NQ from the level, and a 12 point trade in RTY. So there's just a chunk. You know, this system is designed to take chunks with a repeatable, disciplined process in mind that doesn't rely on hindsight for clarity. So just a good example of that. That confluence long sets up the first confluence short. So ES, what is becoming IB high, just above the overnight highs. NQ, you can see here, a very significant level, no hindsight. Monthly pivot point and the weekly R1, and it's a to the tick response there. And RTY coming in from that same supply and demand MR1. RTY has an enormous amount of relative strength. So that is a confluence moment there, right around 9:30 central, 10:30 eastern. RTY just stalls while NQ ends up traveling 200 points or so, 150 points or so from that significant level. It's just a relative weakness versus relative strength thing. That is a definitive confluence moment, same window of time with everything at levels. ES really not so much, but NQ and RTY very much so. We don't decide what the market's going to do, and so NQ just has a conclusive move down as per its relative weakness from monthly pivot point and weekly R1, which are perfectly stacked there just above the gap fill. RTY really more just stalls at the level. Relative strength in the Russell, relative weakness in the NASDAQ. So that's the second. That was the second confluence signal at highs there, and that will set up the third confluence signal, which is a very, very clear long, which happens around 9 a.m. my time Pacific, so 11 central. In Q, you can see a little response there from what we call trend guide, the daily S1. That's a little quick 30-point trade. From the highs now, it's 150-point trade in NQ. So take a look. This is where this is clear. So these levels, again, marked in advance. No hindsight needed for them to be clear. You can see them all coming into these levels at the same moment in time. So RTY is now, you know, very shallow retrace. Look over here on the regular trading hours chart, maybe clearer. Shallow retracement into the supply and demand. Monthly R1 just below with surf. NQ at the lows, supply and demand. And just shy of that weekly pivot point, just came just below it. Notice the little divergence process into the low. Marginally lower low that traps poor quality hands on the short side and frustrates and punishes buyers with stops below that prior low. ES, same moment in time, dick for ticks, the intraday pivot point and the upper end of supply and demand. So same moment in time there. It's about 11 central, as I said. And that is a 15-point chunk. Almost 20-point chunk in ES there, just back to the highs. in NQ. It is exactly a 100-point chunk from the middle of supply and demand to the middle of supply and demand. That's 2,000 to contract. That's real money. And RTY is going to travel here 20 points up into its key significant level to the upside. Supply and demand with the quarterly R1 and the weekly R3. They're waiting just above. And that will be the last confluence signal of the day, which is incoming here. But again, confluence long here on the open, supply and demand, supply and demand, supply and demand, and then a short with that NQ level, monthly pivot point, weekly R1, and the gap fill, travel all the way down to in 11 central, ES, dicks for tick the level, but it's about the confluence lens. It's not about levels in one instrument. If you had been a supply and demand or an intraday pivot point trader in ES, there's nothing there. I mean, there's a shorter time frame, A, B, C, D. I can't draw it because it's a video, but A, B equals C, D perfectly. But other than that, nothing really there. But look at the same window of time. RTY and NQ both had clear and definitive levels. So now we set up this epic short. So what you'll see at the highs here is very, very clear levels in all three indices at the same time. RTY is already there. It's QR1, weekly R3, and supply and demand. That's three very significant higher time frame pieces of evidence. And Q is coming back to the overnight highs and back to the RTH highs. That's monthly pivot point and weekly R1. Two very significant pieces of evidence. So RTY and NQ are there. NQ is getting 10 points through, gets a little through. Now ES joins at this moment in time. So RTY is six points through. And Q smashing through, gets that marginally higher high. Look at it collecting the naked point of control there, an additional piece of evidence, very common in the confluence system. A divergence, a marginally higher high, just excoriate these sellers at monthly pivot point, weekly R1, but collect an additional piece of evidence and trap a bunch of poor quality buyers buying some perceived breakout. And at that same moment in time that all of that is happening, ES comes into weekly R2, and supply and demand. So these three levels, in order to display that none of this comes from hindsight, I'm going to play a clip from our pre-market strategy video on this day. This is done 90 minutes before the RTH open. So 4 hours before the price action that you're seeing here. Take a look.
So this is our huge level right here in the ES. This level, which is this level, this primary level, this is our big level for the day if we get up there. Obviously, this whole big area, we've talked about it over and over again. It's like ES. If it, both of them could come into the area at the same exact time. It's just a big level all the way from this high. Swing high, swing high, swing high, swing high, swing high. Come back up and test it again and could break down.
So here we are to those key levels. And news breaks, breakdowns in the relief talks for the American economy. That's 40 points faster than you can fill in ES. That's 200 points faster than you can fill in NQ, 180. Look at where we bounce on that move, first move down. ES bounces at weekly R1 monthly pivot point. NQ bounces at weekly pivot point supply and demand. RTY bounced at MR1 supply and demand. Then we break through. Where does NQ go? Quarterly pivot point in 20. Tries to bounce. Where is ES now? Supply and demand. Where is RTY now? Supply and demand. These bounces are big. These bounces are big chunks. They may be too fast for, you know, trader A or trader B to trade, but NQ, that's a 50 point trade from the 20 EMA. ES, 20 points from the supply and demand. RTY, 10 points from the supply and demand. This news is big, though, so this auction is, the value of this auction is migrating lower pretty swiftly. RTY there collects the weekly R2 and gap fill, and we'll go down to the last confluence signal of the day. This is now a 60-point chunk in ES, 200, almost 300-point chunk. Yeah, it's almost a 300-point chunk in NQ, $6,000 a contract. And ES bounces at the weekly pivot point and the 20-day exponential moving average there at the lows. You see that almost to the tick? NQ at the lows, gap fill in supply and demand. This is quick, but you can slow this down. It's a very orderly level-to-level process in space. It's just very swift in time. And that doesn't mean you have to trade it, but I'm just showing from the anatomy of the day, from a confluence perspective, this is a migration of value from level to level to level to level. RTY still trying to bounce at that weekly R2 after the low is supply and demand. NQ bounced at supply and demand and gap fill. ES bounced at weekly pivot point in 20 EMA. And the last moment of this will be a little divergence process. This is a nice bounce. That's a 20-point trade from weekly pivot point, 20-day exponential moving average. It'll be a 30-point trade from it, back up to supply and demand. Here we get a real shallow but very valid kind of counter signal. Look, ES, daily S1, trend guide, supply and demand from below. Same moment in time, NQ, weekly pivot point, supply and demand from below. RTY, just shy of the MR1, trend guide, daily R1 from below. That's a quick chunk, 20 points up, 10 points back down. Now 20 points back down in ES. Looks like nothing on the chart because of the range established by the news event. But these are real chunks, and you can see it's level to level. Even with a healthy amount of skepticism, you can't deny these concrete and definitive levels. It's the auction, the value is just migrating from level to level. And so the last thing into close is ES is going to come down and collect this quarterly pivot point and gap fill. This was also in the pre-market strategy video on the downside. We thought this level might hit first on the downside, then travel to the upside. It happened in the opposite direction. We don't know what the market's going to do. And we just sort of close. We make this little divergence process into the close with ES, with making marginally lower lows, but then collecting additional key pieces of system evidence. And that ended up setting up a gap up the next day, Wednesday the 7th, enormous gap up, because we did this little, we call it sort of how markets bottom, a little divergence process into key system levels. So ES here is a 30-point chunk from the reshort at the supply and demand, with NQ, weekly pivot point, supply and demand at the same moment in time, RTY levels, same moment in time. And you can see here, ES is going to collect a marginally lower low, supply and demand, gap fill, quarterly pivot point. That's going to be the low. NQ, not really anything there. Just shy of supply and demand so far. But you can see RTY down there, supply and demand, just above that annual pivot point. And that'll be the low. I think maybe it goes a few ticks lower into the Globex close and reopen, but then gaps up huge the next day. So,
hope you enjoyed the presentation. A look at the anatomy, if you will, of a given session through the Confluence lens. You can tell we're passionate about our work, so I hope that comes across and that you learn something that you can use in your trading on Monday. One thing it's important to say here is, none of this is to claim that we're perfect traders or that we're catching every single one of these moves. Trading is never going to be like that. It's a craft characterized by error and improvisation and confusion. You're never going to get everything right. It's not a hard science, and it's certainly not a perfect science. I make mistakes every day, and I miss trades every hour of every day. What it is to say, what we meant to display, is that this is a repeatable process for taking pretty significant chunks of profit out of the market on a disciplined and repeatable basis. Taking chunks out of the market from level to level without needing to rely on hindsight or hoping for a given trade to become a home run. It's a repeatable process. It was designed with consistency in mind and clarity in mind, the kind of clarity that does not rely on hindsight. Everything's clear in hindsight. This was designed for clarity that doesn't need hindsight for insights. And I hope you got a sense of that. Hope you have a great rest of your weekend and you had a chance to donate to a great purpose. Cheers.
Ah, yeah, I'm back. Yeah, I'm back. Let's talk about it. Call that who the best, this and that. Let's talk about it. Call that who the best, this and that. Let's talk about it.